What's happening? What's going on, guys? And welcome back to another episode of the Fish and Chips Movie Reviews! I'm Matt Fish Fischioni.
And I'm Chips Sam Chips
and
Cohen.
And welcome to the one, the only talk show where we talk about movies, we review movies, and we recommend movies as well. Thank you all for joining us for yet another episode. Sam, it is that one time a year where films come together and it's practically the big stage for movies.
This is movie holiday.
Movie holiday this for all
where,
of us.
This is where we as moviegoers have to decide what is the best of which.
Yes.
And by this, we mean we are talking about the Oscars. The Oscars are so close. You can almost taste it.
I can probably smell it in my mouth.
I smell the victory.
Sweet victory. So, yeah. Because it is Oscar season, we decided that we make our predictions to you guys, explaining why we think that these nominations are going to win in our honest opinion. So first, the first category we picked was Best Animated Film. Which is, the nominations are Incredibles 2, Isle of Dogs, Mirai, Wreck-It Ralph 2, and then Into the Spider-Verse.
Which is a Spider-Man movie. So for this, we're probably going to just give our honest opinions on both movies or who we think was probably going to win. Mm-hmm. But honestly, what I would say is that anything that is in this, that is in a category that's like nominated is obvious, has done everything great. They're fantastic, and everything that they got to get into these nominations is fantastic. We're not going to be able to decide. It's the Academy, but what we can do is this thing like, you know, who do we think is going to win? And I think for this, I know who's going to win it. I have a really good feeling I know who's going to win it. I feel like it's going to be Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Mm-hmm. The animation is fantastic. The story is great. It's very nice to see, like, you know, this kind of like animation in it. Mm-hmm. Although I did see we both saw Incredibles 2, but then I also saw Isle of Dogs. Mm-hmm. And I really like, and this movie is made by Wes Anderson. I really like Wes Anderson, and when it comes to stop motion animation, he has done a very good job. Mm-hmm. He did fantastic on a Fantastic Mr. Fox, and I do think maybe some there he might be able to win something, but in this sense, I kind of do think it's probably going to be Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah, and it's funny that you mentioned that, because growing up with Incredibles 2, this was literally 14 years in the making, and with this kind of story and this kind of comeback that Disney has made, it was truly a remarkable feeling going into the theaters and seeing Incredibles 2. The animation is awesome, the storytelling and the overall comedy, the feel is absolutely fantastic. I also saw Isle of Dogs, which reminded me a lot of Fantastic Mr. Fox. Not sure if you saw, but I grew up watching that as well, and it had the exact same feel. I loved the animation. I loved how the talking dogs had some character into it, and the overall story was good. But I got to give it to Into the Spider-Man, because I truly believe, I'm not sure if you can too, but this is the best Spider-Man movie that we've gotten since Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man 2.
That's something.
And it's, I don't know what it is, but it's just the way that the character is being portrayed, not by Miles Morales and all the other Spider-Man, but the actual hero of Spider-Man and what he stands for himself. That, to me, is a huge part of this movie. And for that reason, I'm also going to say that Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is going to win the category for Best Animated Film.
Yeah, and now we have to go to, and there, here's another category we're probably going to go through, and that's Best Original Song. That is, and then the nominations for that is All the Stars from Black Panther, I Will Fight from RPG, this documentary on Ruth Bader Ginsburg, a Supreme Court judge, mm-hmm. very big into the women's rights, The Place Where Lost Things Go from Mary Poppins Returns, Shallow from A Star Is Born, and When a Cowboy Trades his spurs for Wings from The Ballad of Buster Scrooge.
Yeah, I'm going to have to say that based on its popularity and its overwhelming of hearing it from the radio so many times, I think that the clear-cut winner yeah. is going to be shallow. You cannot.
Really? Yes, I have a different.
Shallow.
I have a different one.
Because whenever I enter into the dining hall here at Dean College, I always hear the song Shallow. It has gained so much popularity from the movie, and we hear it from the radio like so many times. It won the Golden Globe for Best Original Song. As a matter of fact, that category was the only thing that stars were actually won in the Golden Globe. So I'm not sure how the actual movie is going to go, but as terms of Shallow, I think that's going to win the Oscar for that.
I mean, as much as Shallow is a good song, and it definitely was one of the songs that probably made the soundtrack fantastic, as well as the movie very good, I'm probably going to say it might not, because of the popularity of all the stars, I believe. And because, I don't know, I have a feeling because of Kendrick, and I think her name is SZA, mm-hmm. Making all the stars very good and making it probably the song that single-handedly made was one of the songs that made Black Panther pretty good. Mm-hmm. I do think it's probably going to be one of those songs that's going to probably just take it or just steal it right from Shallow. It might come right out of the Shallow. Yeah. And I don't know. I have a feeling that's probably going to win. I don't know much about any of the others. All I know is that of the RPG. I do want it to kind of win documentary. Mm-hmm. But again, it's based on who wins popularity. All Stars going to win it, or is it going to be Shallows? And if it's Shallows, that's fantastic for not only Bradley Cooper, but also Lady Gaga, who is an actual singer who everyone I believe wanted to go see that movie for.
Yes.
So. I don't know, you might go with Shallows, but I might go out of the Shallows and go with All the Stars.
Really? Well, it's actually funny you mentioned Lady Gaga, because she's also part of our next category as Best Actress,
yes.
where she is also nominated for Best Actress Award. We also have Yalitza Aparicio from Roma. We got Glenn Close from The Wife, Olivia Colman from The Favorite. And then finally, Melissa McCarthy from Can You Ever Forgive Me? This one, to me, was hard to predict, because before I saw the Golden Globes, I initially thought that Lady Gaga was going to win Best Actress. However, when I saw that Glenn Close, someone that I have never heard of before, only from the fact that on the same night I found out that she actually played Cruella de Vil from 101 Dominations.
Which one?
The first ever 101.
You mean the animated one?
Not the animated one, but the live action one.
Oh.
So yeah.
Okay. So I was about to get very excited for her to that she's out there doing something else than a live action. But
right.
But now just hearing it's I didn't really see that. So it's I don't
really. Really,
so
you never saw that.
I've never seen the live action anime. The live action of 101 Dominations. I like the original one. It's my favorite. Besides that song, Cruella de Vil, it's fantastic.
Yeah, but, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
So what's recall? This one is kind of hard for me to choose, because you have Lady Gaga and you have Glenn Close, two who I believe were literally neck to neck as the people who would thought who would win Best Actress. I'm honestly going to take a risk and say Lady Gaga takes home the Oscar for Best Actress.
I'm probably going to say the exact same thing, because as much as I've seen this movie. I've not really seen any of these movies. I do know that any of the others movies, I think any person who wins Best Actress, actress who wins Best Actress is definitely going to be, definitely shown that she did very well. I think when I first see Melissa McCarthy in Best Actress, I kind of think to myself, who messed up?
Right.
But, if she really did a good job with this role, then probably that's a good thing for her.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the movies I remember seeing her in are just kind of bad comedy movies.
Right.
But for her, hats off to her for making it to this, but I don't think she's probably going to win it. But if she does win it, I might just give her a standing ovation.
Right.
Because gotcha. That's something. What we got? We got Best Actor now?
Yeah, we got Best Actor.
And this one's very interesting. So we got Christian Bale from Vice, Bradley Cooper in A Star Is Born, Willem Dafoe from... At Entity's Gate, mm-hmm. Rami Malek from
Malek.
Malek.
Rami Malek.
Okay, from Bohemian Rhapsody, Viggo Mortensen from The Green Book. That's it? Oh, my God.
Yeah, that is it.
So, I see. I feel like because you've seen Green Book, you probably would put him in your list of maybe he might win it.
He's definitely in consideration, but he is not my pick.
Yeah, that's. I was kind of thinking, because I was like looking at like you know this list, and I was kind of thinking like who's probably gonna win it, and I have a feeling it's gonna be between Bradley Cooper and Rami Malek, and I think it's because people really enjoyed his performance with Bradley Cooper. They really liked his performance in Star Is Born, and that ending with him is just oh my god. But with Rami Malek, I kind of have a feeling that he's probably going to take it because it's Queen, and he played probably one of the greatest singers in rock and roll.
Right.
So I have a feeling that it's probably going to be Rami for Bohemian Rhapsody. But if there's anybody else who could probably win it, then I have no idea because this is who I think could probably win it.
Yeah. So my side of this is that you mentioned that Viggo Mortensen from Green Book would be one of my considerations. He was fantastic in the movie and how he portrays this old school Italian man. And basically, I could relate to that character and he played a really good job at it, but I don't think he's going to win Best Actor. Bradley Cooper did a fantastic job playing a badass musician, but when we talk about musicians, we talk about badass. You gotta think Freddie Mercury, Rami Malek. It's scary how he resembles him so much, not only by looks, but also his voice. And, you know, that's the reason why he got that Golden Globe, because in a way, Queen has become such a phenomenon. It's become somewhat of a cult following. And based off those reasons, he won the Golden Globe for Best Actor, and I believe that he's gonna win the Oscar for Best Actor.
We'll have to wait and see, because we have no idea, but we're all very excited for this.
Yes.
But I think nothing can be exciting than Best Picture.
This one
is... I have a lot I have to go with with this. But
same
for
here.
Best Picture, we have Black Panther, Black Klansman,
Bohemian Rhapsody,
The Favorite, Roma,
Green Book, and A Star Is Born.
And Vice.
And Vice.
So, I think, so now, like, you know, okay, so I look at this nice, and the biggest one out there that, like, is a big standout, every single one of these, like, has something special about them.
Yeah.
I mean, Roma is very different from all these because this comes off of Netflix, which usually would never show itself off of, to any movie theater. But I think the one that, like, you know, is a big, like, eye setter is Black Panther, and I really really enjoyed this film. It's a very good superhero film. I've seen a lot of people say when the nominations came out, if Black Panther deserved to be in Best Picture, why wasn't Avengers Infinity War? Where I would say it didn't have much of a it wasn't much of like a fantastic movie to what Black Panther was. Black Panther, like, the characters are fantastic, the story is something, the villain is so complex and so, it's so different from, like, how we would usually see a villain. Usually a villain would just be like, you know, I'm the bad guy, that's it. But this guy's like, no, I have a reason to not like you, and that's why I'm the bad guy.
Yeah.
And
then you can also feel some sympathetic for this character, for what he's been through. And it's stuff like that where, you know, is that what makes really good villains as well?
And I think when I see this, I see Black Panther in this category, I kind of think like, that this movie has gone to a very, has been commercially and critically successful, and a lot of people like it, and you can probably even put it in probably like the same field of like probably the best superhero movie of all or of all time with The Dark Knight of Christopher Nolan, which also was put in the uh, in the Oscars. Not just for visuals, but for best actor or best supporting actor.
Right.
And you know, so this is like a very big like step in like this in like superhero movies because we never see this.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very excited for this movie. I think another movie I'd probably say I'm very excited for in the Best Picture, I'd probably say is Black Klansman. I came into that movie fear kind of like feeling like this is going to be one of those movies that's like all about like, you know, a man who is African American and goes in and like kind of like sneaks himself into the KKK. And the for Best Supporting Actor, that's Adam Driver. He plays a fantastic role in that. So I'm very excited for that. Star is Born, same thing. We've said it. It's a very good film. I'm kind of ready for it. I really feel like those movies are probably going to win it. I would probably say, I said Star is Born when I came out of that film, out of that theater, but I don't really think now if they can really win it.
Right. Well, I'm just going to say this as a wrap up, expect the unexpected. 2 years ago, La La Land was expected to win Best Picture. It came out to Moonlight. So,
if that happens.
So, my prediction, first it was Bohemian Rhapsody, but since with the rumors, with the sex allegations, it's probably not going to work. So, for me, I would have to go with The Green Book. It's one of the categories that I actually liked, and that's my prediction. And on that note, we are all out of time. Thank you so much. So
be sure to watch the Oscars.
Be sure to watch February the Oscars.
24th. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to be watching it, and once it's done, we'll be able to talk about it.
So until next time, I'm Matt.
And I'm Sam.
And tune in for our next episode of the Fish and Chips Movie Reviews.
Woo!
So that's all, folks. I'm Aradetti.
And I'm Alex Fuse.
And this is Dean News Network.
Have a great night.